This week, we'll catch a sneak peek at the Flower and Garden Festival at Epcot.
And we'll also catch a bunch of beads at Universal Orlando's Mardi Gras.
Plus the latest theme park news and more coming at you from the attraction studio at Fun Spot
right now. Welcome to this week's episode of the show. I'm Banks.
And I'm Melissa.
Now, I'm sure you can see right here, we have our usual monthly one-off box unboxing. We'll have that later on in the show. And actually, this week, we're going to give it away. So stay tuned for that.
Ooh, exciting things.
Now, speaking of exciting things, Universal's new attraction, Race to New York, starring Jimmy Fallon, team members are starting to ride it. So we may be seeing some soft opens
soon. Yes, we will. Yep. We'll see.
I hope so, because we're within a month now of its grand opening on April 6th. So usually, you know, rides like to try to soft open to guests within that month. Mm-hmm. No word yet on when that's going to happen, but hopefully you can follow us on our socials. I'm sure sometime very soon, maybe.
Yeah, there's never any guarantees on when it'll open or close or anything like that, but you can always go and try it for yourself.
The only guarantee is that April 6th, it will officially open. Exactly. So take your chances if you want to go see if it's soft open over at Universal Studios. Mm-hmm. Until then, let's get to some news in the queue.
This week's show is brought to you by MEI Travel, our preferred travel agent. For a free quote with no obligation, visit meitravel.com.
Undercover Tourist is our recommended supplier of discount theme park and attractions tickets. Go to undercovertourist.com.
Separately ticketed experiences are coming to Walt Disney World Resort.
Breakfast is about to get a little more magical at Trattoria Al Forno at Disney's Boardwalk. Starting April 2nd, guests will be able to meet Ariel with Prince Eric and Rapunzel with Flynn Rider while enjoying their meals at the Bon Voyage Breakfast character dining experience.
The character dining experience will cost $34 per adult and $20 per child and will include a variety of themed plated options for breakfast.
The California Grill at Disney's Contemporary Resort will give guests the opportunity to enjoy the Magic Kingdom Fireworks Spectacular from a private observation deck while sipping drinks and savoring snacks.
Reservations for the new celebration at the top are now open for select Sunday evenings from February 26th through April 16th. Cost for that is $99 per person. Complimentary valet parking is also included.
And finally, guests can get a closer look at the majestic African elephants at Disney's Animal Kingdom and learn what it takes to care for them at the Caring for Giants Tour, a family-friendly backstage viewing experience of the park's African elephants.
Caring for Giants will be offered several times daily beginning March 12th and cost $30 per person.
A lot of cool stuff. The elephant package, that tour looks really, like, I would love to do that.
Yeah, $30 isn't too bad for that either, for a really cool kind of backstage experience and up close and personal with them. That's pretty neat.
For what it would take to take your family out to eat at a restaurant in Animal Kingdom, just use that and go get an awesome behind the scenes experience.
And I really want to do the Trattoria Al Forno breakfast.
Yes. It's not often you actually get to see Prince Eric
and Ariel together. Yeah, exactly.
Or
at all, yeah.
And the fact that they're bringing that character dining to the Boardwalk, which I don't know if they've ever had any in the past, but I can't think of anything. Mm-hmm. So it's nice to see them getting into the character dining. Mm-hmm. Now, Skyplex, an upcoming multi-million-dollar entertainment complex, plans to bring SkyJump, a 500-foot free-fall diving experience from the top of Skyscraper Tower to their future location on International Drive.
Not only will guests drop to the ground 450 feet below them while experiencing SkyJump, but in the middle of the complex is the Skyscraper, which will be the tallest roller coaster in the world.
The company has also announced these won't be the only attractions in the tower, and to quote more specifically, we don't even know the half of it.
Skyplex is shooting for a 2019 opening date.
First off, I mean, we've been hearing about Skyplex for years, so I really do hope this is still coming, this is still happening. Two, you want to make a reservations right now to do this?
I'm good.
It reminds me of a similar thing that they do off the Stratosphere in Las Vegas, where you're strapped to these two strings, basically, that connect from the top to the bottom, and you
just
stand
fall
up there, and you are the one that has to make that step off.
I'm getting flashbacks from our Sky Coaster experience, and I feel like that is nothing compared to what this sounds like. So.
I would probably do it. I'm going to say it right here. If this does open, I will do it.
I am quoting you on that. And I will not be joining you, but I will be your cheerleader.
Hopefully we don't have to use this episode in a flashback in 2019 where I have to eat my own words.
We're using it. Don't delete it.
Can we do another take with that? I want to say something. No.
Anyways, no. Moving on. We'll remember that later, though.
Oh, great.
Cabana Bay Beach Resort at Universal Orlando is now testing relay room service robots for delivering items to guest rooms.
The 3-foot-tall relay uses Wi-Fi and onboard cameras and sensors to find its way around corners and along corridors.
It also calls the elevator wirelessly and automatically alerts the guest once it arrives outside the room.
Technology. What the heck?
I know. I'm just picturing like little robots wandering the halls, knocking on your door.
It's like, wow, like, wow, 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 wow.
Yeah.
Wah, wah.
You open your door and you're just like, hello. Oh, thank you. Wine.
Do you tip the robots?
I'm not sure how this is going to work. You don't tip the robots.
That's insane. I love the future, but at the same time, I feel like there's some sort of like Skynet type thing too.
Yeah. It's like semi creepy, but also kind of cool. And I don't know. Maybe they'll have more space for the employees to do other things. I don't know.
We'll see if they expand this to the other Universal resorts, or if Disney starts doing something similar, or you know. Well, I mean, this is obviously the first of its kind, at least that I've ever seen. I had no idea this type of robot existed. So
I think it's cool that we just think about technology like this, like, oh, it's never going to happen, but it's starting to happen.
Oh, here we go. Yeah. Future. Now, Comcast NBC Universal, the corporate owners of Universal Orlando and Universal Studios Hollywood, will soon have full control of another Universal resort when they buy 100% of Universal Studios Japan later this year.
The transaction is expected to have finished taking place this April, well before the opening of Super Nintendo World, an expansive area featuring characters and their game worlds from Nintendo.
I know we talked about this an episode or two ago about the ownerships of all the Disney parks around the world.
Yeah.
So let me just say, I never knew that Universal didn't already own 100% of Universal Japan.
I know. I guess it's not something you really think about.
No.
Because the Disney one was a little bit more out in the open, but I didn't really realize it either.
Yeah. And the Japan park is going to be the first one to be getting these Nintendo mm-hmm. worlds. So I mean, I don't know what this is going to mean business-wise for us, but maybe mm-hmm. some of the stuff that they do in Japan could find its way over here. Like, because Japan's Wizarding World, they do some fun stuff that we don't do here, like
right.
Christmas, Halloween. They have some really cool things.
Yeah, now with Universal owning all of it, we'll see how that will translate to us.
See it. Come here. Please, come here.
Hi, everybody. Let's return to Disney Springs to look for some hidden Mickeys. Go to the landing to Raglan Road Irish Pub and Restaurant. Inside the restaurant, a girl with Mickey ears is at a table at the left middle of a painting on the wall behind the stage. Very neat. Happy hunting.
Fun Spot America wants to thank you for 19 huge years. Celebrating people, creating fun, and making memories is our promise to you. And in 2017, we're proud to announce the Mind Blower. It's a wooden roller coaster that goes upside down. That's right, a wooden roller coaster going upside down. It's a one of a kind in America. So bring your friends, bring your family, heck, bring your in-laws, because you're gonna have your best day ever.
Elisa, repeat after me. Laissez le bon temps rouler.
What?
Laissez le bon temps rouler.
What are you saying and why would I want to say it?
Just give it a try. Laissez le bon temps rouler.
Laissez le bon temps rouler.
Okay, that's good enough. It's French for let the good times roll, and that's exactly what they're saying every day at Universal Orlando right now.
Oh yes, their Mardi Gras event is in full swing.
That's right, and we sent Haley out to check it out.
Take it away, Haley. Laissez le bon temps rouler.
We're here at Universal for the Mardi Gras Parade. It's back and it's bigger than ever, so let's go see what's new.
out to Universal before the parade and the concert to get some authentic Mardi Gras food. They even have king cake. I think I'm gonna get a slice. So where's your favorite place to watch the parade?
My favorite place, I've got two places. Over in front of Horror Makeup is a really good place for guests to stand because one, you see the parade come out and then you see the parade leave at the end of the night. I also love the long alleyway next to Finnegan's. It gets so much room for you to back up. If you're a bead catcher, that's a good place to be.
Okay, and what's new for the parade this year? I heard you have new floats this year. Can you tell me a little bit more about those?
Yep, we've got a brand new theme this year, which is mythical creatures. That means six brand new floats, six brand new sections of costumes to go with those floats. Some of the floats you're gonna see this year are Garuda, Manticore, Chinese Dragon, Pegasus, lots of very, very cool. Oh, Phoenix is beautiful. So when you come out, be sure and look at all the detail on the floats. We've worked with Kern Studios out of New Orleans for years. They've been a great partner. They help us keep this as authentic as possible.
The Mardi Gras Parade takes place every night between now and March 25th. And if you want to see a concert, make sure to head out on a Saturday night.
The next time you plan a Disney vacation, book with a travel agency that's been specifically designated as an authorized Disney vacation planner. Unlike some other agencies, many of our agents' exclusive knowledge of Walt Disney World can help you get the most out of your vacation, and the assistance of our travel professionals can help you get a customized Disney vacation that's just right for you, your family, and your budget. Start planning your magical vacation today by visiting mousefantravel.com.
Skip the lines with undercover tourists, crowd calendars, touring plans, and mobile apps. Stop paying full price for your family vacation and visit Undercover Tourists today.
This year's Flower and Garden Festival at Epcot has just begun, so we thought we'd give you a look at what's in store.
Every year, the event seems to unveil some amazing new topiaries. I heard this year's no different with the addition of a new bell.
No spoilers, let everyone find out for themselves.
As y'all know, we're now doing, when we do our face characters, we're actually working with our character artists to make sure that our characters, our topiaries look like the character. And I think they've done a great job on Belle. Of course, she's now our fourth one we've done this to, the first being Snow White, of course Anna and Elsa, and now Belle. The thing I always like to tell people about this really is an individual piece of Disney artwork. I think when people see our topiaries, they think in the old days when it was just, you know, kind of plants, kind of sculpted to look like the topiaries. This is not that. We work with the same character artists who did the artwork for your t-shirts or the sculpts, the exact same people work with us on our topiaries. Not only the face parts, but the figures and everything as well. So that truly is work of art created by Disney artists, one of a kind. When we're doing our topiary frames, if you were to see her unplanted, she'd look really weird because her dress would be way too small. When we're making this, we know ahead of time that you're going to have 3 to 4 inch plant material on that dress. So you have to kind of make it truncated, where her torso, that's less than an inch of plant material. So you make it about the actual size. What you're doing for the actual body, the skin, the hair, this is actually a sculpt. A Disney sculptor has created a sculpt that fits perfectly with our frame. And of course, you can imagine it's not just taking a picture. They're out here working continually. And then of course we do the art on it to make it look botanical. And then you have to have a way to attach the sculpted artwork to the growing artwork. I gotta say, we first did this with Snow White 3 years ago, or four, 3 years ago. We truly did not know if it was gonna work. Even the artist said, we're not sure this could be successful. It's one of those things you actually have to try it. Well, we tried it and of course it worked. So now we're in the process of making all of our face characters look like this. Really is fun because, you know, we've been working for so long to bring our topiaries to life, and I think this finally is the highlight of what we'll get. I can't say that we'll ever get a more lifelike topiary than you have right here.
So we have two new marketplaces for the Flower and Garden Festival. We have Northern Bloom and we have the Berry Basket. So the Berry Basket is really everything berry. We have a seared lamb chop with blackberry gastrique, a little bit of couscous and quinoa underneath. We have a mixed green salad that has some fresh strawberries, some blue cheese, and then we have a berry buckle that has a mixed berry ice cream that has a little bit of black pepper in there. And then from Northern Bloom, We have seared scallops that has some French green beans, butter potatoes from Canada, a little bit of smoked bacon, vinaigrette, and really Northern Bloom is really about Canada, about French Canadian, but it's not just the two marketplaces. We also have a lot of new menu items in our outdoor kitchens, from a great new dessert in Bauermarkt, which is a warm cheese strudel with some mixed berries, as well as a potato pancake with applesauce. And then La Isla Fresca, we have a sugarcane skewered shrimp, a little bit of coconut lime sauce, and steamed rice. And then we have some returning items as well, with the smoked salmon tartare and the potato and chive biscuit. We have the German currywurst with paprika chips.
We have some very colorful products this year. We have a couple of different art designs that we're looking at. Very vibrant, very geometric pattern, little hints of Figment added in, stylized Mickey and Minnie. We've really built on some of the successes we've had from previous years. We are trying some new things though. One of my favorite items is the headband. Headbands are extremely popular at Disney parks, and being able to incorporate this headband with a Figment and Minnie and this kind of stylized, even a little nod to Spaceship Earth in the very center there, is gonna be, I think, a big win. Dooney and Burke handbags continue to be extremely popular too, and this year we're gonna introduce a Weekender style bag, which is an oversized bag using that kind of geometric pattern. But the art was designed by Disney Design Group, and you're gonna have kind of a main logo pattern here that's used on a variety of different items, apparel and pins and magnets and mugs and such. The geometric styles I mentioned with the headband, turvis tumbler, things like that. And then there's a landscape pattern with Mickey and Minnie that look like they're landscaping from that. There's also a male point of view, which is more just kind of the festival logo itself, and that's going to be probably on some more muted tones. Headwear, there's a t-shirt that goes along with it too. The nice part is that we are opening the festival center this year for the first week. We're going to have it open every day, and then some weekends you're going to find it open during the weekends only. And then you'll find a lot of these products throughout Epcot. And then we're gonna offer select items on Shop Disney Parks app coming once the festival launches. The only items that won't be found immediately, we're not sure if we're gonna be added in the future, would be the Dooney and Burke handbags. One last thing is the Eggstravaganza returns to Disney Parks. This time we're gonna have it for the duration of the festival. So it's kicking off on March 1st, running through the end of May. And again, that's the fun scavenger hunt. You can go out, look for the Easter eggs that are taking hidden throughout at World Showcase, and then redeem that for a fun little prize. So again, a lot of fun taking place here at Epcot International Flower and Garden Festival, and hope to see you there.
When you're at Universal Mardi Gras, you'll most likely be very busy catching beads. But for those who really, really, really love beads, you'll want to station yourselves farther back or in a higher spot if you can. Float riders are instructed to throw far. For maximum beads, you'll also want to sit near the beginning of the parade route, as that's where you'll be able to see the parade twice, once on its way into the park and once on its way out. Plus, the float participants will be pumped up at the beginning of the parade and eager to get rid of any remaining beads by the end.
Have you downloaded our free Attractions Magazine app? It features news articles, as well as every issue of our magazine, available right in the app. Plus, catch up on all episodes of the show and even view all of our online videos in one place. Download the app for free in the App Store today.
This week's shout-outs go out to James and Jean Cowie from Glasgow, who are arriving in Orlando this week. Yay. Hope you guys have a great time while you're here.
And happy birthdays to Lee Cockrell, Chanel Creamer, Tom Kennedy, Jennifer Bisbee, and Brian Myers.
We also have a winner for our D23 Nine Old Men contest from last week.
Yes. Congratulations to Heather Burrell from Andover, Minnesota. Stay tuned for another giveaway in a bit.
And now we want to thank MEI Travel, our preferred travel agent for cruises, Disney, Universal, and all your other vacation planning needs. For a free quote with no obligation, visit meitravel.com.
And thanks to Undercover Tourist, our recommended supplier of discount tickets to Orlando and California attractions. For more information, visit undercovertourist.com.
And thanks to Fun Spot America, Central Florida's only family-owned theme park. They provide safe, clean fun in Orlando and Kissimmee. Visit fun-spot.com for tickets and more information.
Remember, you can watch a brand new episode of the show each week on YouTube and iTunes.
You can also visit attractionsmagazine.com for news and videos throughout the week, and find us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Snapchat, and Instagram.
If you enjoy our show, please support it by subscribing to our magazine through our website, in our app or on the Nook or Kindle.
Our winter issue features stories on the Muppets, new roller coasters, and much more. Get your copy at attractionsmagazine.com.
All right, so let me, if you mind handing that, thank you very much.
Here we go.
The one-up box. This is February's one-up box. I know it's already March, but we've held it over for a week to do the D23 giveaway. So we've already opened it. I've already looked in. I'm personally subscribed, and I got mine a week ago, and I'm an impatient person, so I looked in mine already. So this is what we got this for this one. And we're going to be giving all this away to you in a little bit here.
All right, here we go. Batman t-shirt. That's kind of cute.
Then we got, this is all themed to villains.
Villains.
Enemy. Enemy is the theme. So, and then here is a tie. It is a Super Mario themed tie with some of the enemies from Super Mario.
That's kind of cool, actually. I didn't see that before. What? That's a cool tie.
Yeah, I like that. And there's one up box.
A Harley Quinn baggage tag. Mm-hmm. That's super cute.
Then we have Pokemon fans will know Team Rocket, of course. This is a sticker.
Suicide Squad vinyl figure.
Now, the one I got in this one, I got, yeah, go ahead and we'll rip it open. We apologize to whoever's going to win this, so we're going to open it up just so you can see what you got.
Oh, God, there's so many packages.
I got the one that is the gold Harley Quinn and mine back home, so, and this is someone that I have not memorized the characters' names.
That guy. I don't know his name either.
That guy. So there you go. If you know Suicide Squad, then you got that guy.
Cool.
So there you go. That's we're going to be giving this away. So visit attractionsmagazine.com/the show and click on this episode to find out how to enter to win.
Thank you so much for joining us, and we hope you'll tune in again next week.
Until then, visit your local attractions, try something new, stay safe, but most of all,
have fun.
While enjoying their meals at the Bon Voyage breakfast, whoa, where would that come from? Bon Voyage breakfast. We'll do that again.